Hello, I'm Micah Smith from Denver 7, and welcome to Denver Decides. This community partnership is dedicated to accessible and transparent elections. The partnership includes the League of Women Voters of Denver, Interneighborhood Cooperation, and is presented by Denver 8 TV. Our mission today is to present a candidate forum in anticipation of the general election coming up on Tuesday, November 3rd. Among other offices, this election includes the candidates vying to represent constituents in Colorado State House of Representatives from District 2. District 2 encompasses parts of Central and South Central Denver. Our format is a pretty standard one. We will begin with opening statements that will be followed by rounds of questions that have been submitted by the organizers of the forum. Since we do have a time limit, we may not be able to get to all of the submitted questions. All of the responses will be timed. Our countdown timer is right out front for easy viewing. I need to advise our viewers here that there are two candidates on the ballot for State House District 2. Representative Alec Garnett, the incumbent, as well as a candidate for re-election, was invited to this forum but chose not to participate. So let's begin by meeting the other candidate on the ballot, hoping to represent Colorado State House District 2 as your next state representative. On my left is Victoria Partridge, whose name will be second on the November ballot. Welcome, Victoria, to this forum.
Thank you.
And one more note to you, Victoria, on behalf of our viewers, we sincerely urge you to be honest, direct, and forthright to help the viewers distinguish one candidate from another. We will begin with a one-minute opening statement from Ms. Partridge. Go ahead.
Thank you for having me here. I want to thank everyone in the studio for giving me an opportunity to be heard today. My name is Victoria Partridge. I'm a candidate for State House of Representatives, District 2. I've lived in Colorado most of my life. I'm a graduate of the public school system here in Colorado. I've been in the House District 2 for 6 years. I am not a politician. This is my first race, and have had the opportunity to get out and talk to many of the members of my district in House District 2. It has been a great privilege. I've been able to hear what their concerns are and their needs for this district. Something about myself, I've been a flight attendant for 16 years. I've been employed since I was 15 years old. I know the value of hard work. Something that I've been taught as a flight attendant is to be of service to others. I will bring that service to others and the value of hard work to the state legislature.
Thank you. Now our first question for Ms. Partridge, and you will have 1 minute to answer. Is the state collecting enough tax revenue to do an adequate job of enforcing the marijuana industry?
Thank you for that question. I believe that the tax revenue for the marijuana industry is not being utilized in the way that it needs to be. Our education system is still a problem. They said that the taxes for the marijuana would go to our education and our children in their schools. I'm not seeing that happening. I would like to see the revenue from the marijuana be utilized a lot better for our children in their schools in the education.
Now our next question for you, Victoria. If you believe climate change is real, what measures would you support to reduce the effects of climate change on public health?
Thank you for that question. Climate change is happening, and we need to start doing something about it. As a candidate for House District 2, I've gotten out and been able to talk to the people and hear what their needs are. They want to see more bicycle access here in the city. They want to see better public transportation here in the city. And as a candidate, and when I'm elected, I will make sure that that happens and we have better bicycle routes, safer sidewalks, and better public transportation for the members of my district.
And here's the next question from our former forum organizers. Do you believe that climate change is human created? And if so, is it a problem that requires serious public action now? And do you believe that there is a new normal in the weather? And if so, what is your plan to deal with this impact on us?
Thank you for that question as well. I believe that climate change is happening and we need to do more about it. And I think some of the solutions will be better public transportation, better sidewalks, having more bicycle routes for those that want to ride a bike to and from work or to go visit friends. I think that those are some of the solutions that we can look forward to when I'm elected to office, to have better access to safer streets for our people.
All right. Thank you, Victoria. A reminder here for our viewers. There are two candidates on the ballot for State House District 2. Representative Alec Garnett, the incumbent, as well as candidate for re-election, was invited to this forum but chose not to participate. So let's continue with another question for Victoria Partridge, who's also vying for the State House of Representatives seat from District 2 in Denver. In some neighborhoods, like Marlee in your district, property taxes have increased as much as 25% or more, in some cases possibly squeezing original residents out of their homes. Will the possible repeal of Gallagher lead to even more acceleration of gentrification of Denver?
The repeal of Gallagher will triple our property taxes. How is that a good thing for our neighbors here in House District 2? We do not need to have tripling of property taxes. We need to make sure that our senior citizens, new homeowners, young people that are on a fixed income, or older people that are on a fixed income are able to stay in their homes in this district. Tripling our property taxes is not the answer.
And I just want to clarify, Marlee is not in Ms. Partridge's district, so I apologize for that. Thank you for your answer. And we will continue with the next question from our sponsoring partners. What steps, if any, should be taken to curb gun violence in our communities?
Thank you for that question. We need to make sure that our police are fully funded, that they can get out there and protect us from the gun violence that is happening. I believe that defunding the police is not the solution to gun violence here in House District 2. We need to support the men and women in blue and make sure that they have the tools that they need to get out and protect us.
All right, that brings us to our final question for you, Victoria. Who are the major contributors to your election campaign?
Thank you for that question. The major contributors to my campaign are not lobbyists or large corporations. The major contributors are the people of my district. I am proud to say that many members of my district and those outside of my district that believe in what I'm doing and believe in what I have to say have been supporting me. Individuals that want to forward the campaign of Victoria Partridge.
Thank you. A final reminder here for our viewers. There are two candidates on the ballot for State House District 2. Representative Alec Garnett, the incumbent, as well as candidate for re-election, was invited to this forum but chose not to participate. So now Victoria Partridge is also a candidate to represent District 2 in the Colorado House of Representatives. You will have a minute and a half for closing statements. You may begin.
I'm asking for your vote. I know how valuable your votes are, and I know how important House District 2 is to each of the members of my district. I've had an opportunity to get out there and talk to everybody, and I want to continue to help each and every one of you. I believe in House District 2. I will be there for you. I will be available in my office for you every single day. I will be available for your phone calls and to answer your questions. Alec Garnett is not here today, and he hasn't been here for us in our House District. I will be here for you. I'm asking for your vote. Believe in the future of House District 2. We can have a better House District. We need more. We need change in Colorado. I'm Victoria Partridge. I'm asking for your vote.
Thank you for joining us, Victoria. Our thanks also to the Denver Decides partners, which include Inter-Neighborhood Cooperation and the League of Women Voters of Denver. Denver Decides is presented by Denver 8 TV. Remember, Election Day is Tuesday, November 3rd. Make sure your voice is heard and be sure you are registered and be sure to vote. For complete election information online, go to denverdecides.org. I'm Micah Smith from Denver 7 News. Thanks for joining us.